Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Lab series on current sense amplifiers. My name is Chuck Udegboy, and I'm a product marketing engineer in the current and position sensing product line. In this video, we will discuss the most common design considerations for current sensing, including high side versus low side, input common mode voltage, measurements currents range, bi-directional versus unidirectional currents flow, and output type. Let's start with a quick recap on what makes a current sense amplifier special. First and most important is their unique floating input stage, which allows for common mode voltages much greater than the supply rail. Second is the integrated precision gain network that maximizes accuracy and minimizes drift. On the right is a list of questions you should ask yourself before starting your design. The following slides will look at each question. The concept of low side or high side sensing was introduced in session 1 of this video series. A high side implementation has the shunt resistor placed between the supply voltage and the load, resulting in the common mode voltage being essentially equal to the bus voltage. In many applications, this can be well above the supply rail of the amplifier. High side sensing allows for the system to not have any ground disturbance and to identify ground shorts. A low side implementation has the shunt resistor placed between the load and system ground. This is the most common method to monitor current since the common mode voltage is essentially 0 volts. However, this also disturbs the ground seen by the load, as well as prevents the detection of load shorts to ground. Next, let's revisit the input common mode voltage range. If you're measuring on the high side, the common mode voltage is typically the bus voltage being monitored. You need to choose an amplifier that includes this high voltage plus any needed margin with its common mode voltage range. For low side measurements, as stated previously, the common mode voltage is essentially 0 volts. So you need to choose a device that includes 0 in its common mode range. The specs table shown here illustrates a device with a common mode voltage that can go several hundred millivolts below ground. While the current's range itself does not derive any amplifier specifications, from it you can derive several key application constraints: the necessary R shunt value, the required gain of the current sense amplifier stage, and the minimum differential voltage requirements. The implications of these constraints, including R shunt selection and the effects of offset voltage on system accuracy, will be discussed in later videos. Next, we will look at the concept of current flow directionality. In many applications, the currents may flow in both directions. One simple example is a battery charging or discharging. In order to determine which direction the current is flowing, the current sense amplifier must have an additional reference input pin that can be used to set the zero current output voltage to some non-zero level. This allows the output voltage range to be divided such that the system is sinking current when Vout is greater than Vref and sourcing current when Vout is less than Vref. This is shown in the diagram on the bottom right. The last application constraints we'll consider is the output type. Many current sense amplifiers have an analog output, either voltage or current. If the current's measurement results will be used for feedback or control of another analog device, then choosing an analog output makes sense. If the system simply needs to respond to an overcurrent condition, a current sense comparator with an alert output may be sufficient. Finally, if the current information will be processed by a microcontroller, then choosing a digital output device on an interface like I2C or SPI may be the best choice. There are many application requirements that will help determine the best current sense amplifier to use for any given system. This session has introduced 5 of these requirements. What may be the most important requirements? Accuracy, will be the focus of later videos in this series. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Please try the quiz to check your understanding of the content. For more information and videos on current sense amplifiers, please visit ti.com/currentsense.